Greetings. I want to have a civil discussion with you, brother. There is much to be discussed in an honest and adult way regarding your religion, Islam. Yes, I do call it Mohammedism, because that is the only accurate name I know. It is a religion completely different than the religion of the prophets of God. I suppose you can simply get mad and throw a tantrum that I call Mohammed's strange new religion Mohammedism. But I stand safely on the authority of the prophets of God, brother, and the Son of God. Even the Christians and the Jews of his day rejected Mohammed and his claims. And before the modern marketing repackaging, it was called Mohammedanism by no less than Winston Churchill and other scholars. How dreadful are the curses which Mohammedanism, Islam, lays on its votaries, besides the fanatical frenzy, which is as dangerous in a man as hydrophobia in a dog. There is this fearful, fatalistic apathy. Winston Churchill. The fearful, fatalistic apathy is speaking of Inshallah and the hopelessness against your arbitrary Allah, brother. The fanatical frenzy is not really a new extremism, as we are told today. Yes, brother, I have seen the many claims made to defend Muhammad. I am familiar with the grocery lists of excuses and arguments used to attack the Bible. I've made nearly 400 videos addressing and dismantling every such claim Islam has produced. And of all the videos I have made, not one has ever been refuted by a Mohammedan. Rather than have any facts, Mohammedans call me insulting names. Islam attacks and rejects facts by calling the teller of truth a liar. But even as I was preparing this video, Islam again attacked Dar al-Harb. Innocent people in Paris murdered and slaughtered by Islam. And I know the standard arguments you will make. Islam is a religion of peace. All religions have extremists. It is the Zionists' fault. But none of those excuses or claims are true if you honestly examine the world. Only Islam attacks and murders innocent people. Only Islam divides the world into the part it controls and all else as Dar al-Harb, the house of war, the world to attack. Only Islam still allows kidnap and slavery in the modern world. And the Islamic State is faithfully following Muhammad. Only you know what you think in your heart, brother. I think most who follow Muhammad cheer inside when they see Islam strike the infidels. The only regret you have is for the response and backlash you may personally get. Still, it confirms what you think Islam teaches, that Islam will dominate the world. It sickens me when I see Muslims dance and rejoice and celebrate at murder for their Allah. It makes Islam look like a religion of pure evil. And saying such, even with the supporting facts and reason, you still think I hate Islam without cause. But you only know half the story, my friend. And the other half is the kicker. The Bible has foretold of a great religion that will arise in the last days. But great does not mean wonderful or good. It just means vast, many followers. The religion described will deny God is the Father of Jesus Christ. There is one religion that makes such a claim as a core value, Islam. The Bible has foretold of a great religion that will murder Christians. There is one religion in the world that promotes and encourages killing Christians, Islam. Islam will arise because the Bible has foretold it. But what the Bible says teaches that Islam is evil and from the devil or Satan himself. Islam insults God. Now I am going to surprise you. I expect Islam will win its war against Europe. As much as liberal Europe tries to distance itself from Christianity, it cannot, because Christian civilization places value on each man, woman, and child. So liberal Europe, even running from Christianity, can never consider the only solution to the problem. Islam, however, does not value people, never has, and never will. Islam is willing to slaughter millions to bring the Mahdi. Islam will win because liberals are too busy trying to insult Christianity. Islam will win in Europe because Europe is too busy hoping Israel is destroyed once and for all times. But they, and Islam, are wrong, brother. Zechariah 14:1, Behold, a day is coming for the Lord, when the spoil taken from you will be divided among you. This is Prophet Zechariah, brother. Recall that Islam tells you to say you believe the prophets. Do you think it might be good to read what Prophet Zechariah said? For I will gather all the nations against Jerusalem to battle. If you look at the world, the actual armies are not yet gathered at Israel's border specifically to attack Israel. But I think in the not-too-distant future, we will see this happen. And the city will be captured, the houses plundered, the women ravished, and half of the city exiled. But the rest of the people will not be cut off from the city. Then the Lord will go forth and fight against those nations, as when he fights on a day of battle. This is the Lord God, brother, fighting against all the nations attacking Israel. When Almighty God fights for Israel, brother, you will not want to be his enemy. Just take a deep breath, brother, and think. What is the common attribute of all the nations that want to gather and destroy Israel? I have no doubt that for a time, ISIS, the real face of Islam, will flourish. I do not hate Islam, brother. I know it is evil. But that is not hatred. Knowing Islam is evil is simply the irrefutable knowledge of the situation. Islam serves a purpose in God's plan, brother. This is why you should study what the prophets revealed. Isaiah 10:15, Shall the axe boast itself against him who hews therewith? Or shall the saw magnify itself against him that shakes it, as if the rod should shake itself against them that lift it up, or as if the staff should lift up itself, as if it were no wood? Islam and the Antichrist serve God to chastise Israel. Islam is a tool God will use to cause Israel to turn back to God and cry out for Messiah. Behold, I have created the smith that blows the coals in the fire, and that brings forth an instrument for his work, and I have created the waster to destroy. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. It will get very bad for Israel in the coming years. But the prophets who foretold it also said how God would deliver them. So do not get too excited when Islam seems to be winning. Zechariah 12:2, Behold, I will make Jerusalem a cup of trembling unto all the people round about, when they shall be in the siege both against Judah and against Jerusalem. And in that day will I make Jerusalem a burdensome stone for all people. All that burden themselves with it shall be cut in pieces, though all the people of the earth be gathered together against it. In that day, saith the Lord, I will smite every horse with astonishment, and his rider with madness. And I will open mine eyes upon the house of Judah, and will smite every horse of the people with blindness. And the governors of Judah shall say in their heart, The inhabitants of Jerusalem shall be my strength in the Lord of hosts, their God. In that day will I make the governors of Judah like a hearth of fire among the wood, and like a torch of fire in a sheaf. And they shall devour all the people round about, on the right hand and on the left. And Jerusalem shall be inhabited again in her own place, even in Jerusalem. The prophets foretold, who keeps Jerusalem, my friend. The Lord also shall save the tents of Judah first, that the glory of the house of David and the glory of the inhabitants of Jerusalem do not magnify themselves against Judah. In that day shall the Lord defend the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and he that is feeble among them at that day shall be as David, and the house of David shall be as God, as the angel of the Lord before them. And it shall come to pass in that day that I will seek to destroy all the nations that come against Jerusalem. My friend, take Prophet Zechariah's message seriously. And I will pour out upon the house of David and upon the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and of supplications. And they shall look upon me whom they have pierced, and they shall mourn for him, as one mourns for his only son, and shall be in bitterness for him, as one that is in bitterness for his firstborn. Remember, this is God who has been speaking through Prophet Zechariah, God who has been defending Israel and Jerusalem, God who said he was pierced by the inhabitants of Jerusalem. Please allow that to sink in, brother. God said by Prophet Zechariah that the inhabitants of Jerusalem would pierce him. God said this hundreds of years before Jesus came to Jerusalem to be crucified and pierced. You have an opportunity, brother, to learn and respect the prophets, because they reveal the real message of God. May the God who defends Jerusalem allow your heart to open to him. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.